Hello, welcome to this week's Dividend Cafe. We are end of the month of May, and we're much further here into earnings season. And then here we go again with more geopolitical events and even more U.S. domestic political things perhaps involved in the markets. I think there's a couple of things this week that are big news headline events that are not big market impacting. And then there's the other side that is probably more at play into markets, and we'll talk about that as well. But let's talk about two pretty substantial world events that took place this week, neither one of which I think moved the market a penny. And that is, first and foremost, the widely expected massacre of Marie Le Pen in the French election. Macron has successfully been elected the president of France after the kind of wild primary that they had a couple weeks ago. Once we got down to those two candidates, the data was overwhelming that that's how the outcome would go, although the polls really had him winning by about 20%. He ended up winning by over 30%. But be that as it may, the European climate, the notion, there's two different mistakes I think people are going to make. One is believing that this really far-right, nationalist, populist, anti-Euro candidate who lost so big, Le Pen, that is indicative that perhaps the tides are turning away from a lot of the populism, nationalism that Brexit and President Trump and Marie Le Pen somewhat quasi-represented. And I think that'd be a big mistake. I think that the overall primary election was clear as could be. The status quo was rejected by the French voters, and that throughout Europe, they have a very similar dynamic to what we have in the United States, which is a very different apparatus in the countryside and rural areas versus the inner cities. Ultimately, a broader Euroscepticism exists in much of Europe, but it is a dangerous mistake to assume that one country represents the interest of another country. It is not a monolithic environment. And we think that politically, and then more importantly, economically, that neither is this sort of populist, nationalist, anti-immigration and anti-trade dynamic at all running away with things, but nor do we believe that the world is about to turn back to Brussels for their wisdom and economic policy direction. The truth is somewhere in the middle. It's going to be very difficult for Macron to lead. He's not going to have a strong mandate in their parliament. And ultimately, with Brexit taking place in Britain, I think the reliance that Europe has had for growth and even solvency on a hyper-aggressive monetary policy means that Europe is somewhat pigeonholed. Markets had totally expected it. Markets did not move based on Macron beating Le Pen because it was totally expected. As far as the President Trump's rather surprising decision to fire FBI Director James Comey this week, there was a lot of speculation that this would call into question the stability and the momentum and the political unity needed to move forward with tax reform and other things. And I gotta say, we are really just seeing all of these things that we talked about pretty much since the election playing out, where now markets are even sort of shrugging off the realities of the political volatility. The notion that a tweet President Trump sent was ever going to move the markets materially, and a press conference, an announcement, and the next headline, and the this and that. It's a very unique presidency, and regardless of what side of the political fence one is on, most people would agree there's a lot of uniqueness to it and novelty. But the markets don't care for good or for bad about President Trump firing James Comey, because the markets believe, I think rightly, the tax reform is going to get done. And the markets are far more concerned with that aspect of this president's agenda than they are anything else. So to the extent that we're headed towards some place where repatriation of foreign profits can happen, corporate tax reduction can happen, there's a whole lot of sweeteners that may or may not be part of eventual tax bill. We're still waiting for what the Senate will do with the House's now passed Obamacare repeal, but you get my point. A lot of political drama right now, very little market drama around it. So then you say, well, what really is kind of moving markets? And I think first of all, you got to understand that we're 4 days into this particular market week, and we never know exactly what Friday will create. But the market's down 100 points in the week. It's basically right there at its all-time high. NASDAQ, S&P hit all-time highs this week. The Dow is just, you know, a few points below it. So the market's in a wait-and-see mode, but then now at this point we're well past 75%, 80%, I believe, into earnings season. Overall, earnings season has been overwhelmingly positive. There were a couple setbacks with some individual companies this week, and that affected those companies' stock prices. So as earnings go, so will go the market. And when earnings season ends, we have more of a lull. But there's not any big surprises expected from U.S. monetary policy. I've told you our viewpoint on where the European climate is. And so it's a good time for investors to check their allocations. We want to trim things that have run a long way, rebalance the portfolios, but not make any material tactical adjustments, as neither the interest rate environment, the fiscal policy environment, or the geopolitical environment warrant it at this time. That's our view. We're executing very faithfully, and we intend to continue doing so. So if there are any questions at all, please reach out to us. Definitely read dividendcafe.com this week. There's a lot of great material there, and we look forward to coming back to you next week with what we're sure will be more political drama, if not market activity, to discuss. As a matter of fact, I'll be taping next week from the SALT conference in Las Vegas, the world's most amazing hedge fund symposium, and we'll be surrounded with some just incredible hedge fund managers and movers and shakers, things of that nature, and we'll try to report on all that next week. Thanks for listening to Dividend Cafe.